Racing to the 2024 Kentucky Derby, and this time we go to the Saratoga of the South. It's Oaklawn Park, and time for the Rebel Yell at Oaklawn Park. We've got 13 horses entered, all part of a big day of racing that does include the Honeybee. And when you take a look at this 13-horse field from the rail out, it did draw a field of 13. Remember, a mile and a 16th, Saturday, February the 24th at Oaklawn Park, and this is the championship series. 50 points to the winner of the Rebel Stakes, and that'll get you into the Kentucky Derby starting gate. Let's take a look at this field. Starting off at the rail, we've got Carbone. Carbone comes in with two wins. He started off his career with back-to-back wins for trainer Steve Asmussen. He won at Churchill Downs, blew him away by seven, then won by four at Oaklawn Park. He did a pop and stop at Oaklawn in the Southwest Stakes. He faced some more speed, faded back, but he turns around quickly here for trainer Steve Asmussen. Northern Flame picked up a win the last time out for trainer Ken McPeak. Held off a 30-1 shot down the stretch in Mena. Those two get a rematch here. Common Defense, another Ken McPeak runner. He is a long-fused runner, should be closing late. I like the fact that he's got a win at Oaklawn Park, and he does got some stamina influences in the pedigree. Number four, Tejon Pass, was second in the Renaissance Stakes at Oaklawn Park. Meanwhile, Dimatic, out of the fifth post position, another one trained by Steve Asmussen, who also trains Carbone. This one's a Winchell Thoroughbreds, broke his maiden, his last race by three lengths, was kind of green down the lane, kind of jumped away from the rail, then straightened out late, won by three. He's by gun runner. He got that last win in the slop, and Steve Asmussen sends out Dimatic. The likely favorite is going to be Timberlake. He gets post position number six. Good post position off the layoff. Had some good stakes experience as a two-year-old. He won the Grade 1 Champagne. He ran fourth in the Breeders' Cup Juvenile, did Timberlake. Next Level has been running some races on the front end. The last race, he came off the pace. He goes for trainer Keith DeSormo. Meanwhile, trainer Steve Asmussen sends out Laganos, who set the pace in the last race. He also has come a little bit off the pace. Laganos, definitely one to watch in this race. Mena, second last time out to Northern Flame at 30-1 at Oaklawn Park. The coach sends out the multiple stakes place runner in Just Steel. Just Steel going for Dwayne Lucas, ran in the Smarty Jones, then came back. Last time out, ran a big up race. Going to try to compete here out of post position number 10. Woodcourt, nine lifetime starts, was claimed for 50K. And Time for Truth, the quick turnaround, broke his maiden first time out, came back in a race, sprint race, now stretches out to a mile and a 16th. And that one out of the post position, when you take a look at the post position, that's going to be a wide post position for the Rebel Stakes. Let's take a look overall, some of the top contenders in this race. Again, we've got runners with wins at Churchill Downs. You've got runners coming in from the fairgrounds. Carbone, a local base runner. Couple of maiden winners at Oaklawn Park. But I think the top contenders could be overall Just Steel, Carbone, Time for Truth, Timberlake, Common Defense, and Northern Flame. I think any one of those six could possibly win here. I think Timberlake probably going to be the big favorite based on the betting in the Kentucky Derby future wager. Timberlake also bet down in that Champagne Stakes. His best win has been in the slop, so he should be able to handle a sloppy surface if it comes up sloppy at Oaklawn Park. Let's take a look at the race replays, how they got here. Starting off with Carbone, look at this impressive win at Oaklawn Park. Drew away from the field. Now, he got by with some soft early fractions in this race. Steve Asmussen trains, and Carbone has speed. But what do you do about that pop and stop the last time out? And he's got to go against other horses, and he drew the rail. Timberlake, a nice win in the Champagne Stakes, ran fourth in the Breeders' Cup. Let's go back to that Champagne Stakes. You know, the big favorite in this race was Fierceness. General Partner took the lead heading for home, and Timberlake pulled away down the stretch. He did finish second in the Hopeful Stakes. That was to a long shot, Nutella Fella. And he does have a slop win. We'll see what Timberlake can do for trainer Brad Cox. Meanwhile, Northern Flame, a win at Oaklawn Park. Last time out, he defeated Mena, who's another runner in this race. Mena comes after him And repelling that bid down the stretch was Northern Flame, a stretch-long battle. They're going to try to hook up again here in the Rebel Stakes. Meanwhile, Common Defense disappointed me a little bit the last time out. Now ships back to Oaklawn Park, where he picked up a win. Ken McPeak, always dangerous there. 1-for-3 lifetime. Got some stamina influences in his pedigree. Smaller, light-framed horse. He should like the slop if the track comes up sloppy. But Common Defense, definitely a contender here in the Rebel Stakes. And another one to look at is Dimatic, a maiden special weight. Last race out at Oaklawn Park. You see him kind of spook away from the rail. Then he kind of had to regather himself in mid-stretch. Pulled away to the three-length win, did Dimatic. He's by Gunrunner for the Winchell Thoroughbreds and trainer Steve Asmussen. A nice big field of runners here at Oaklawn Park. Let's take a look at the 6-furlong pace. Starting off with Carbone. I think he'll have the lead early on. The presser is going to be Timberlake, Northern Flame, Just Steel, and Time for Truth. Time for Truth on the stretch out may opt to go to the lead. And then Timberlake, he's been on the lead in a couple of races. He's come from off the pace. I think he's going to want a fast pace and come from just off the pace in this race. I think it's going to favor the pressers overall. Northern Flame seems to be getting good at this time. And also Dimatic, I think, is improving. But again, these are lightly raced horses. They can change their running styles until they get up to 3, 4, 5 starts. The big questions, Carbone, the pop and stop the last time. Timberlake, is he the class of the race with that grade one win and also a fourth in the Breeders' Cup? Northern Flame seems to be improving. And Dimatic, a nice win at Oaklawn Park among the Oaklawn Park local contenders. My top selection in the Rebel Stakes is going to be Dimatic. I like that last win at Oaklawn Park. Also, you know, that was in the slop, but he also shied away down the stretch. I think he can improve here in start number as he gets more starts. I'm going to play him in exactas over Northern Flame, Timberlake, and Just Steel. Timberlake definitely could win, probably going to be the big favorite, but a full field off the bench, and he doesn't necessarily need the lead. We'll see what Timberlake does here. The road to the Kentucky Derby continues. We've got the Honeybee Stakes, the Fountain of Youth, John Battaglia, and the Gotham Stakes, all part of Super Saturday next week. We will be having previews of those races. And then on March 9th, we've got the Tampa Bay Derby as we continue the road. Don't forget the Triple Crown Prospectus comes out every Monday. Free to subscribe. Sign up at the description below. We write about the fillies and the colts on the way to the Triple Crown, all the way through the Belmont Stakes, the Triple Crown Prospectus. And who will join Sierra Leone in the championship series? He won last week. Who do you like in the Rebel Stakes? Leave a comment, a full field. And remember, D. Wayne Lucas always says, people have opinions, horses have the facts.